Over 70 years, a lot of talent has come through KSBW. Many moved on to bigger jobs or retired.
And what we found as we caught up with a few of them is that they do find some interesting hobbies after they leave KSBW.
KSBW 8, count on us.
One of the magical things about music is its ability to take us places.
You're not gonna take me in? Oh!
It is absolutely pouring here.
I never liked you.
And we'll see you again tomorrow.
In Carmel, Brittany Nielsen.
KSBW Action News 8.
Okay, so I want to let you in on a little secret. Here in a back hallway of KSBW is what we call the goodbye board. People move on or they retire and they always sign this. So for old timers like me, this is like a trip down memory lane. So many names. You got Dale Julin up here, longtime morning anchor. He went to our sister station in Savannah, Georgia. And oh, here's a name that everybody remembers. Jim Vanderswan, better known these days as Jimmy V.
In retirement, this is how Jim spends a lot of his time, thus the nickname Jimmy V. At this recent gig, it was something of a KSBW reunion. Adrian Laurent, anchor and news director in the 90s, Lee Schell from back in the 70s.
And I worked for about 18 months from 1971 into 72, and then moved on to KNTV up in San Jose, where I eventually ran the news department up there for about 6 years.
And Bill Murphy, he was at KSBW more than 40 years ago.
Well, I was news director and anchor at KSBW from 1978 to 1985. Most of it anchor, but the last 2 years news director. As a matter of fact, I hired a guy named Jim Vanderswan. You may have heard of him. I understand he did fairly well, yeah?
He did fairly well, yes.
It was a good hire.
Listen up, kids, it's Jimmy V. He's the prince of weather.
A good hire indeed. More than three decades at KSBW as the chief weather guy.
It was Death Valley, California.
Jim saw a lot of changes over the years.
I remember dialing up for like 20 minutes. We could use the outside line to dial up to download two satellite pictures. It took about 4.5 minutes each, you know, to have something to show on the air. And nowadays, I've got more equipment on my iPhone sitting on my butt right now than I ever had in the weather office. You know, it's just remarkable. And I still get stopped once in a while on the street. People say two things that I always appreciate, that they learned something from me about the weather, and that they relied on me for the forecast.
Those clouds are going to lead to other things that may cause problems for some.
I appreciate all the people who've been so supportive. So that's the part you really feel in your heart.
Now, KSBW Weather with Jim Vanderswan.
Fantastic day today.
Jim Vanderswan, still a legend.
This is like the good old days for us. We used to do this every week.
Every Friday night.
Yep.
This was our bread and butter. I loved it.
Another guy you might all remember, the Dean of Sports, Dennis Lennon.
First of all, I apologize for wearing green. I know you're a big Giants fan.
He's retired too, but still involved with the Salinas Valley Sports Hall of Fame. Also, still goes to the occasional Friday night high school football game.
Enjoyed working with you and Dan Green, and before that, Dina, Jim Vanderswan.
Oh, yeah.
Lee Solomon is still there. And I must mention Drea, who's done an excellent job.
Hasn't she? Our sports anchor, Dennis Lennon.
Yeah.
I've watched
her Friday night football thing better than I did it. I'm not kidding. It's,
I don't think she would agree with you.
Well,
she'd say if I could live up to the team, it'd be good enough.
They're still at every game, and she doesn't fumble all over her words like the Dean might do on a Friday night.
Self-deprecating, as always.
I remember being called the Dean everywhere.
His jersey has been retired and still hangs in the rafters in the studio.
Is this not national?
Pretty close, but not exactly.
Summertime, and the living is easy.
It's sometimes hard to think back before Drea and Dennis, but back in the day, there were some players who went on to big jobs in big markets.
You know, in this business, you run into a lot of eccentric characters and you have a lot of great stories. And I gotta say, some of the most eccentric characters and best stories came from those 5 years at KSBW. Good thing we didn't have social media back then. Anyway, happy birthday, KSBW.
How is Joe Fonzie? He's been working up in the Bay Area in sports for almost 30 years now. So many names on the board. We have Art Jarrett. He's at our New Orleans station. Alani Letang. She's in San Diego. Oh, Christopher Salas. He's, of course, in Washington. Oh, and here's a name we cannot forget. Joseph W. Heston.
It's a very personal expression that I think to thank our veterans.
One of the unique things that Joe has done in retirement, joined a nonprofit called Bugles Across America.
I played years and years back and I auditioned. There's 4,000 of us across the United States in Bugles Across America, and we provide live taps for veterans' funerals rather than the recorded taps that the government uses now.
Joe was the boss at KSBW for 22 years before retiring. Viewers most likely remember him for his weekly editorials.
Speaking on behalf of the editorial board is Joseph W. Heston.
Why do we do editorials?
I do miss talking to people on the platform that we were blessed to have at KSBW to bring up issues that somebody needs to say something about. I miss that.
But for the most part, Joe is enjoying retirement.
Here we go.
All right, yeah.
More time to volunteer.
And somebody paid to shave
How
it off on live
pay?
Television. How much did we get for that?
$10,000.
More time for his church. More time for family. And paying respects to our veterans, one note at a time. Phil Gomez is living his best life in retirement. He married his longtime love, traveled to England with his brother, and picked up a few side gigs along the way, including driving diners to the Shadowbrook restaurant.
I think I'm the only person that dresses up like this, the only driver, and I just do it for the fun of it. And people really enjoy that, and they really enjoy the stash. So that's one of the other things too. People might not recognize me immediately, but once they see the stash, they might say something.
The mustache is hard to forget. It came late in his career, but quickly became a trademark. 42 years in the news business, almost 25 at KSBW.
And I still get people walking up to me saying, "Phil, we miss you." And that's always nice. That's always nice to hear.
But fear not, if you're around Santa Cruz, chances are you'll see him, the man with the stash. And speaking of hard to forget,
I'm Dena Ruiz Eastwood.
Dena Ruiz's life reads like, well, a movie script. She married a Hollywood legend, which took her away from the KSBW anchor desk. That was back in 1997, but she still misses it.
Working at KSBW was easily one of the top five pinnacles of my life. It kind of defined me as an adult. It opened a million doors.
And it did lead to some incredible life experiences.
And here we are.
But in the end, the Clint Eastwood fairy tale did not last. She did, however, find her happily ever after.
Sons of my own.
She remarried and settled into a new life. Maybe a little less glamorous, but still patented Dena. A house full of rescue dogs, most of them seniors, because, well, they need a little extra love.
Tango's a good boy.
A fierce focus on her large extended family.
Scott C. Eastwood completed his first day in the AT&T National Pro-Am. I was pretty proud.
Breathe in.
An online tribe that gathers for stretch classes several times a week, and most of all,
thank you with love and gratitude.
Gratitude for how things turned out.
We're together every day. It's great. Every time I see him walk through the door, I go, hubba hubba. I've known the guy 43 years. 43 years, yeah. And it, not for one second is that blush off the rose, man. It's wonderful.
Gotta tell you, that was fun. That was fun to put that together.